This is the Vernier flow rate sensor. It's used to measure the flow rate of a stream. And the way it works is that you're going to put this impeller into the water. And as the water flows past it, it turns this, and there's a magnet in here, and it basically counts the number of revolutions. And it comes pre-calibrated so that it knows that however fast it's going, it can determine what the stream velocity is. Now, when you use this in a stream, you want to make sure that you point this end upstream and that you keep this part off the bottom of the stream so that you don't run it into a rock. You don't want to damage this. Now, the device comes taken apart, and so to put it together, it's very easy to do. And so all I have to do is put the pieces together. And this gives me a handle where I can put it down into the stream without having to bend over and be able to do that. So all I have to do is put that together. There we go. And so now we've got the device together there. Now, the flow rate sensor comes with a 5-meter cord, and the reason for that is it allows you to maybe collect data without having to go into the stream, or at least your collection device. You may have your collection device on shore if you wanted to. Maybe one student goes out into the stream with the flow rate meter while the other student is on shore, and so that's why we have that. The device can be wet up to this point. So this is the electronics. This part needs to stay dry, out of the water. Now, there's a couple other pieces, or actually three other pieces that come with it, and these are extensions on here designed to allow you to be able to place it down at different depths of the water, and I just put them in my pocket. So this allows you to control the depth that you place the impeller in the water. So that's just basically a standoff from the bottom of the stream bed. So it just comes with that. I'm going to use the LabQuest 2 for data collection today. So I need to plug the flow rate sensor into the device. It's an analog sensor, so it plugs into an analog port. I've plugged the flow rate sensor into channel 1, and we have a little reading there. I might want to zero the sensor since it's not in the water, and like tearing a balance, you're just saying, I want it to read 0 now. Now I'm going to do something else, which is change the screen contrast. I'll be outside, so it'll be easier to see. And to do this, I will go to the little house, I go to preferences, go to light and power, and then down in the lower left-hand corner, there's a high contrast mode, and when I close that out, it will change the screen into a black and white. Makes it easier to see outdoors. Now, if we take a look at this part of the screen, we see our default collection parameters. It's time-based, so we look at flow rate as a function of time, 1 sample per second for 3 minutes or 180 seconds. That's fine for some experiments, but I want to use a mode we call selected events. And what selected events will let me do is go to specific points in the stream and have it measure the velocity at that point in the stream. So I'm really interested in a specific site on the stream there. So to change this, I just go to where it says mode, and I'm going to go up the top, and I'll use the pull down there, and I'm going to go down to selected events, and it comes up here and it says event name. So you don't have to change that. Sometimes you might change it to site in this case because I might be interested in different sites along the stream. So to change that, I just tap where it says event. The keyboard pops up. I'll type in the word site. And say done. And so I've got it here where it's naming site, and the it won't actually have any units because it's just a location there. And I'm actually going to do this. I'm going to check the box next to where it says average over 10 seconds. And what will happen there is that when I have it collect, it's going to collect for 10 seconds but display an average value for the collection there. So I'm fine with that, so I'll hit OK. And so now I'm ready to collect some data. Now what I'd like to do is show you how this would work. It's going to be difficult to actually film in the river doing the data collection. And so what we'll do is I'm going to hit the collect button, and then I'll start spinning the impeller, and I'm just going to start spinning it there, and I'm going to hit keep, and just keep spinning the impeller for the entire time. And so what it's doing right now, it's making measurements, and it's going to do that for 10 seconds. And then when 10 seconds is done, it will actually display the value there. And so then we end up with that point of data. And so that's how I'll be doing the data collection out in the stream. Now let's go collect some data. So now that I've set up the device for data collection, I'm ready to begin. So I need to press the collect button. And when we do that, we end up with the keep button right next to it. And what will happen is that when I press that keep button, it's going to measure for 10 seconds, because I set up that average over 10 seconds. And it will display an average velocity at this site, which is what I called it, and display that as a single point of data. And so at this point, I'm ready to actually do the collection. So I will stick it into the water, hit keep, and I'll just wait until it's finished. And there we go. So now I can move to a different location. So I've moved to a slower part of the stream, so I might want to make a measurement here. So I put it down into the stream, hit the keep button, and then hold it there until the 10 seconds has elapsed. So I've moved to another site, even closer to the shore, and I suspect maybe that the stream velocity is slower there. Let's make a measurement. So I put it in the water, press keep, and it's going to collect the data for the 10 seconds. Now I move to a part of the stream where the waters really seem to be flowing pretty strongly here. So I will hit the keep button, and I'll just wait until it's finished. So now we've finished collecting data, and we'd like to take a look at it. So look at the graph here. I've got the four points where I collected the data. And probably for this, you'd just be interested in the values at the various points here. So if I wanted to know the value of the very first point, if I tap on that point, it actually tells me what the velocity is for the stream at that point. So 0.639 meters per second. At that point, if I go to this point, then it tells me what it is there in the meter, so it's a different value. And I could just in turn tap on the different points and be able to look at those values in the meter. So we've seen the use of the flow rate sensor, measuring stream velocities. So you know, you could use this with students who are maybe monitoring stream flows different seasons of the year. So as a part of an environmental science study. So if you wanted to do something like that, then this would be the sensor you would need to use.